We welcome you to the Going Beyond program, to the glory of God, and we know that you are going to be blessed even as we join the word of God today. The Bible says that God sent his word, healed them, and delivered them from their destruction. So as you hear the word of the Lord, may you be delivered from any form of destruction that the enemy intended against you, in Jesus' name. See you after the service and enjoy the word of God today. Amen.
The season of grace.
And everybody
hear me. From the Easter period, from the time of the Easter this year. Until now, and I don't know until when. We are in a season. And God is calling and giving to us that season called the season of grace. What is grace? God, grace is God's unmerited favor. What is grace? Grace is God's ability, God's power working for man. What is grace? Grace is the power to become. What is grace? Grace is God's riches available at Christ's expense. That's what grace, if you do it as a synonym, G, we have G, what, where is the word grace? G, L, A, C, E. G stands for what?
God.
And then?
Riches.
R stands for what?
Riches.
A stands for what?
Art.
C stands for what?
Christ.
And E stands for expense. Everybody say with me, God's riches.
God's riches.
At Christ's expense. Lift up your hand like you believe it. Say, I receive
in this season
God's riches
at Christ's expense.
Somebody say, Oh Lord.
Release.
Your riches
on my life
at Christ's expense in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Give him a shout of victory in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Now why do I say that?
Kwa nini nasema hivyo?
John chapter 1.
Yohana sura ya kwanza.
Verse number 16 and 17.
Mstari 16-17.
Please, everybody read me 1, 2, 3. For the fullness of his grace, we all have received one blessing after another. Say again. From the fullness of his grace, we all have received one blessing after another. Turn to somebody, tell them, from the fullness of his grace.
From the fullness of his grace,
I have received.
And you have received.
One blessing after another.
One blessing after another.
How many have God's blessings by grace? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Why have we received from the fullness of his grace one blessing after another? Why?
Kwa nini tumepokea kwa utero wa baraka zake baraka moja baada ya nyingine? Kwa
nini? The answer is verse 17.
Mstari wa 7 unajibu.
Verse 17 says, everybody read with me 1, 2, 3. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Read it again. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. When Jesus came,
wakati Yesu alikuja,
he found himself in problem.
Yeye alijipata kwa shinda.
Because the Pharisees and the Sadducees and all the Jews and the Sanhedrin and the elders and the high priests,
maana masondekai na mafarisayo na wote wasewa,
they had a role to safeguard the law.
Waliweza kujaribu kulinda sheria.
And that was what they were looking for. They were fighting for.
Na hiyo ndio walikuwa wanapigania.
Nobody will break the law.
Ya kwamba hakuna mtu atafuja
sheria. They dwelt on the law of Moses.
Wao walisimamia Torati ya Musa.
Little did they know.
Kidogo tu hawakujua.
Jesus came to establish a higher order than the law of Moses.
Ya kwamba Yesu alikuja kudhibitisha kiwango cha juu kuliko sheria.
He never came to fight the law.
Hakuja kupigana na sheria.
But grace.
Lakini neema.
It is higher level of the law.
Lakini neema ni kiwango cha juu kuliko sheria.
And at times grace, what grace is for, it will find itself contradicting the law.
Na sasa neema itajipata ikipingana na sheria.
That is why when Jesus healed a person during the Sabbath,
ndio sababu Yesu alipoponya mtu siku ya Sabato,
he had broken the law.
Alifunja sheria.
But according to grace,
lakini kulingana na neema,
he had something, he had done something good.
Alikuwa amefanya kitu kizuri.
So grace is a higher order of the law.
Kwa hivyo neema ni kiwango cha
juu cha sheria. Can I submit to you that grace is higher than the law?
Ya kwamba neema ni kuu kuliko Torati.
And I heard the Lord say.
Na nikasikia Bwana akisema.
We are saved by grace.
Tumeokolewa kwa neema.
We live by grace.
Tunaishi kwa neema.
We shall make in life by grace.
Tutafaulu maisha kwa neema.
We shall overcome the devil by grace.
Tutashinda shetani kwa neema.
Our children shall be educated by grace.
Watoto wetu watasoma
kwa neema. We shall excel in our marriages by grace.
Tutafaulu kwa ndoa zetu kwa neema.
Our children shall go to the university and they shall graduate with masters and PhD by grace.
Watoto wetu watafaulu katika vyuo kwa neema.
We shall do the work of the ministry by grace.
Tutafanya kazi ya huduma kwa neema.
And listen to me.
Na nisikize.
This nation called Kenya.
Hii taifa linaitwa Kenya.
We remove it from the hands of the law.
Tunaitoa kwa mikono ya sheria.
And we now commit it into the hands of grace.
Na tunaiweka katika mikono ya neema.
Those people you call the Al-Qaeda's and the Al-Shabaab and the Boko Haram's and the people who are doing what it is being called what? Radicalization.
Sasa watu ambao wanaitwa Al-Qaeda, Al-Shabaab na wengine ambao wanaharibu vijana wetu.
They base their radicalization ideologies on the law.
Sasa hiyo mambo yao wanafunza vijana wanaiweka katika sheria.
And that law they purport that is the law of Islam.
Na wanasema ya kwamba hiyo sheria ni ya Kiislamu.
And that they are fighting for Islam.
Na wanapigania Islam.
Only to have the imams and the erite among the Muslim coming and say Muslim have been hijacked. What you are seeing is not Muslim.
Na tunaona akina imamu akitokea akisema oh dini ya Kiislamu imenyakuliwa.
But can you hear me now?
Lakini nisikie sasa.
We are committing this nation from the hands of the law and those who practice the law. We are putting this nation into a higher order and the higher order is called grace of God.
Tunaitoa katika sheria na tunaiweka kiwango cha juu kinaitwa neema.
And hear me.
Na nisikie.
This season of grace.
Hiki kipindi
it will not only affect you.
Aita kudhuru tu.
It will not only affect your family.
Aita dhuru tu.
It will not only affect your business.
Aita dhuru tu.
It will also affect our nation Kenya.
Aita dhuru taifa la Kenya.
It is going to affect the thinking of our president.
Aita dhuru hata kufikiria kwa rais.
That is why for the very first time,
ndio sababu kwa mara ya kwanza,
the president have said we are going to deal with the corruption head on.
Ya kwamba tutashughulikia ufisadi moja kwa moja.
My prayer is one.
Ombi langu ni moja.
Oh God.
Ewe Mungu.
Increase your grace. Increase your grace. Increase your grace. Increase your grace.
Ongeza neema yako.
Upon our president.
Juu ya rais wetu.
Upon the parliament.
Juu ya bunge.
To be able to fight the demon of corruption in the nation of Kenya.
Aweze kupigana na pepo ya ufisadi katika nchi ya Kenya.
My prayer is one.
Ombi langu ni moja.
Oh Lord.
Ewe Bwana.
Increase your grace.
Ongeza neema yako.
In our nation Kenya.
Katika taifa letu
Kenya. That we may be able.
Ili tuweze.
To rise.
Kuinuka.
Above the threats of the Al-Qaeda and the Al-Shabaab and whatever network of terrorism. They are not going to scare us. They are not going to prevail. They are
shame.
It's over.
Wana in the name of Jesus. katika jina la Yesu.
How many are with me?
Ni wangapi mko na mimi?
Why am I talking the way I'm talking?
Kwa nini nasema vile nasema?
I have heard God.
Nimesikia Mungu.
What has he said?
Amesema nini?
He has said he has given us a season and it is called the season of grace.
Ametupa majira kipindi kinaitwa kipindi cha neema.
When you enter the season of grace, what appeared impossible to do there before, it becomes possible to do.
Wakati umeingia katika kipindi cha neema, kile ulikuwa uwezi fanya kinafanyika kinatendeka.
And that is in John chapter 5.
Na hiyo iko katika Yohana sura ya 5.
We see a man who was a cripple.
Tunaona jamaa alikuwa kiwete.
He was staying at Bethesda.
Alikuwa anakaa pale Bethesda.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
And when he was there for that 8 years.
Na alipokuwa pale miaka 38.
In a certain season.
Ka pale wakati fulani.
An angel would come and steer the water.
Malaika angekuja atibue maji.
And anybody who enters first.
Na mtu wa kwanza kuingia.
Would be healed of whatever ailment.
Angepona kutokana na ugonjwa.
And the man was there that 8 years.
Na jamaa alikuwa pale miaka 38.
When Jesus appeared.
Wakati Yesu alitukia.
He asked him, "Would you want to be healed?"
Akamuuliza, "Ungependa kuwa mzima?"
And he said,
akasema,
"I have no man."
Mimi sina mtu.
To throw me.
Wa kuniingiza.
When the water is stirred.
Wakati maji yamefurika.
Little did he know.
Kidogo tu hakujua.
Jesus himself was the grace of God.
Yesu mwenyewe alikuwa neema ya Mungu.
Jesus is the grace.
Yesu ni neema.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
With the grace of God working in your life, you don't require a man.
Kwa neema ya Mungu ikifanya kazi maishani mwako, hauhitaji mtu.
With the grace of God who comes into your life, what you could not do in that 8 years, you are able to do it in a fraction of 1 hour.
Wakati neema ya Mungu imekuja maishani mwako, kile ungefanya miaka 38 unaweza kifanya kwa lisali moja.
Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Unasikia kile na
how many are together with me?
Wangapi wako
na mimi? I prophesy to somebody.
Ninatabiria mtu.
What you have not been able to do in 10 years, in this season of grace, you are going to do it just like that.
Kile ungeweza kufanya miaka 10 iliyopita, utakifanya hivi tu.
What our nation was not able to do in 50 years, we are going to achieve it in this season of grace.
Kile taifa ingefanya miaka 50, tutakifikia wakati huu wa neema.
Now this morning,
asubuhi ya leo,
I want to talk about,
ningependa ninene kuhusu,
another grace or still a wrong grace, something called the grace to manifest.
Sasa kitu kinajulikana kama neema
ya kudhihirisha. Somebody lift up your hand and say, "Oh Lord,
ewe Bwana,
release in my life,
achilia maishani mwangu,
the grace to manifest,
neema ya kudhihirisha."
Lift it again, say, "Oh Lord,
ewe Bwana,
release in my life,
achilia maishani mwangu,
the grace to manifest,
neema ya kudhihirisha."
Now, what does that mean to manifest?
Je, kudhihirisha inamaanisha nini?
To manifest it means,
kudhihirisha inamaanisha,
to show plainly,
kuonyesha wasiwasi.
To manifest it means,
kudhihirisha inamaanisha,
to appear,
kuonekana,
to appear,
kuonekana,
to appear,
kutukia,
to appear,
kuonekana.
To manifest,
kudhihirisha,
it means,
inamaanisha,
something that has been hidden,
kitu ambacho kilikuwa kimefichwa,
something unknown,
kitu hakijulikani,
but suddenly it appears, it shows up,
lakini kwa ghafla tu kinatukia.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Now come with me.
Jonah.
Genesis 11.
Mwanzo 11.
What I am teaching you is not only in note, it is in my spirit. I have already eaten it.
Kile ambacho nawafunza hakiko tu kwa maandiko, nimeandika lakini kiko kwa roho.
Isaiah was told, "Eat the scroll."
Isaiah aliambiwa kula hii.
Now what I'm teaching you, I have already eaten it.
Kile nawafunza nimekula tayari,
nimetayari. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Genesis chapter 11.
Mwanzo 11.
Come to verse 30.
Kuja mstari 30.
I will show you only two occasions and I'm done.
Nitawaonyesha matukio mawili na nimalizie.
And Terah took Abram his son, and Lot the son of Haran his son, and Sarai his daughter-in-law, his son Abraham's wife. And they went forth with them from Ur of the Chaldees to go into the land of Canaan. And they came unto Haran and dwelt there. Now, it is the father of Abraham.
Sasa ni baba ya Abraham.
What is his name?
Jina lake nani?
Terah.
Anaitwa Terah.
He has two sons. In fact, he had three. But by the there are two this time. Who are they? He took Abraham his son, mm-hmm, and Lot the son of Haran, his son's son. So that means Lot was a nephew of Abraham. True or false? Okay, and then he took his wife Sarai, the daughter-in-law. Now Sarai, okay, let's not go to the details. Where did they come from?
Wametoka wapi?
Uri of the Chaldees. Where are they going?
Wanaenda wapi?
Where are they going? They are going to Canaan.
Wanaenda Kanani.
Did they arrive in Canaan?
Walifika Kanani.
No.
Hapana.
What happened?
Nini kilitendeka?
They came to a place called Haran.
Wakafika mahali kunajulikana
kama Haran. So you can now see Haran. Haran is between Uri of the Chaldeans and Canaan. So they never arrived in Canaan.
Hawakufika Canaan.
They settled in a place called Haran.
Waka jenga makao mahali kunajulikana
kama. Come to verse 31.
Kuja mstari 31.
They dwelt there. Already they have dwelt there.
Wamekaa pale.
But that is not where they were going.
Lakini hawakuwa naelekea hapo.
So they dwelt in the wrong place.
Kwa hivyo wamekaa mahali hapa sahihi.
Verse 32. That says, and the days of terror. You are not reading, you people. And the days of terror. 205 years, and Terah died in Haran. So when they dwelt in Haran, they lived until Terah was 205 years and he died.
Yani walikaa pale mpaka miaka 205 alafu Terah akafa pale.
Now did Terah arrive in Canaan?
Je, Terah alifika Kanani kweli?
No.
Hapana.
He died in Haran.
Alikufia pale Haran.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. How many are with me until now?
Ni wangapi wako na mimi mpaka sasa?
Now let's go to chapter 12 verse 1.
Turudi tuende 12 mstari wa kwanza.
12 verse 1, because it is the one, the verse that follows there. It is chapter 12 verse 1. Everybody, 1 2 3. Now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show you. Verse number 2, 3, 4. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless you, and thy name great, and thou shalt honor that and honor that. He continues with whatever. Verse number 4. Come on, so Abraham departed as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him, and Abraham was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. Okay.
Sawa.
Now,
sasa,
I don't have the argument.
Sina ile mabishano,
because I tried to look in a study for how long they stayed in Haran before Terah died.
Maana nilijaribu kuangalia kwa maandiko alikaa muda gani pale Haran kabla Terah kufa.
But it does not show.
Lakini inaonyesha.
It only show.
Inaonyesha tu
that when the father of Abraham was 75 years, he got Abraham.
Alimpata Abraham akiwa na miaka 75.
And after that,
na baada ya hiyo,
Abraham was 75. Yes, he was already married when they were going there. And he had gotten him at 75. So if you had 75 plus this, that is already
150
years. Yeah. If you minus that from 205, you minus 150. Mm-hmm. What is the difference? 55. Yeah, that is the kind of calculation I was trying to do. I came to the conclusion that they lived in Haran 55 years on their way to Canaan. And finally, his father died and never arrived in Canaan, but he lived in one place for 55 years until he died.
Yani hawakufika na baba yao akafa baada ya kukaa mahali pamoja miaka 55.
Now come to verse number 5.
Kuja mstari wa 5.
Number 5. Everybody, this one is now very important. Everybody read. And And Abram took Sarai his wife, and Lot his brother's son, and all their substance that they had gathered, and the source they had gotten in Haran. And they went forth to go into the land of Canaan, and into the land of Canaan they came. Do you hear that?
Yes.
Now, at which age is Abraham when he is leaving Haran? 75. At which age did he arrive Canaan?
Alifika Canaan akiwa na miaka ngapi?
75. He arrived the same year.
Alifika mwaka ule ule.
Hey! Now listen to me.
Nisikize.
Between Haran and Canaan,
kati ya Haran na Canaan,
it was a distance of less than 1 year's journey.
Ilikuwa muda wa chini ya mwaka moja.
But his father stayed in one place for 55 years and he never arrived.
Lakini baba yao alikaa pale miaka 55 na hakufika.
What was the difference between Abraham and his father?
Tofauti ya Abraham na baba yake ilikuwa nini?
It is in verse, that verse number 1.
Ilikuwa katika mstari wa
12 verse 1. Go back to 12 verse 1.
Mstari wa 10,
everybody read with me, 1 2 3. Now the Lord had said unto Abraham. The difference was the father of Abraham.
Baba ya Abraham.
He started a journey to go to the land of Canaan without God and without grace.
Alianza safari ya kwenda Haran Canaan bila Mungu na bila neema.
Of going there.
Ya kwenda pale.
But his son.
Lakini mwanawe,
his son Abraham,
mwanawe Abraham,
he started the journey with God and with grace.
Alianza safari na Mungu na neema.
How do I know he had both God and grace?
Ninajuaje alikuwa na Mungu na neema?
Anytime you see the word Lord in the scripture, it does not stand for God the Father. It stands for Jesus.
Kila wakati ukiona jina Bwana
Lord,
Biblia,
the word Lord,
Bwana,
it stands not for God the Father. It is Jesus.
Inasimamia sio Mungu Baba, lakini inasimamia Yesu.
That is why when Paul saw the light on the road to Damascus, he fell down and he said, "Who are you, Lord?"
Ndio sababu Paulo alipoanguka akienda Damascus, alipoona giza aliuliza, "Wewe ni nani Bwana?"
What was he told?
Aliambiwa nini?
Come on, I'm asking you. What was he told? He was told, "I am Jesus."
Aliambiwa mimi ni Yesu.
Now the word Lord stands for Jesus.
Jina Bwana lasimamia Yesu.
How many are with me? How many are with me? Now Jesus stands for grace.
Sasa Yesu anasimamia neema.
So the what came in the life of Abraham?
Kile kilikuja kwa maisha ya Abraham.
Was the presence of God.
Sasa ni uwepo wa Mungu.
And the grace.
Na neema.
And as a result.
Na kama matokeo.
Everybody hear me.
Kila mtu nisikie.
He received the grace to manifest.
Alipata neema ya kudhihirisha.
What his father was unable to manifest.
Kile baba yake angeweza kudhihirisha.
I prophesy to somebody here today.
Natabiria mtu hapa leo.
You are in a season.
Wewe uko katika majira.
Where the Lord shall release his grace upon you to make you manifest what your father could not manifest. Yeah. You shall manifest what your father could not manifest. In Jesus' mighty name.
Utadhihirisha kile baba yako angeweza kudhihirisha katika jina la Yesu.
What he could not manifest in 55 years.
Kile angedhihirisha kwa miaka 55.
Abraham manifested it in 1 year.
Abraham alidhihirisha kwa mwaka moja.
Because there was the grace of God.
Kwa sababu kulikuwa na neema ya Mungu.
Somebody lift up your hand with me and say, "Lord,
Lord,
release in my life.
Release in my life.
The grace to manifest.
The grace to manifest.
Your glory.
Your glory.
In my life.
In my life.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus
Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Now come with me in the second case and I'm done. Kuja. John chapter 9.
Yohana sura ya 9.
This scripture we know very well.
Hii andiko unajua vizuri.
It says verse 1.
Inasema mstari wa kwanza.
And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth.
Na Yesu alipokuwa akipita akaona mtu ambaye alikuwa kipofu tangia kuzaliwa.
Verse number 2. And his disciples asked him, saying, "Master, who did sin, this man or his his parent that he was born bride.
Na wanafunzi wake wakamuuliza bwana he nani alitenda dhambi wasasi wake ama huyu mtu ili akasaliwa kipofu.
Come to verse 3.
Kuja kwa mstari wa
3. Everybody, I want you to read verse 3 with me. 1 2 3. Jesus answered, neither has this man seen nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. Bwana sifiwe.
Hallelujah.
Now listen to me.
Kisa.
There is a grace.
Kuna neema.
That makes people.
Ambayo inafanya watu.
To manifest.
Wadhirike.
To manifest.
Wadhirike.
To manifest.
Wadhirike.
Until now.
Baka sasa.
Nobody know who God intended you to be.
Ujui Mungu alikusudia uwe ni.
Nobody know.
Hakuna mtu anajua.
Who you are.
Wewe ni nani?
Until now.
Baka sasa.
There are abilities in you that nobody know.
Kuna uwezo ndani yako ambao hakuna
mtu. Until now.
Baka sasa.
You have not yet seen what God has prepared for you.
Haujaona kile Mungu amekuandalia.
Hasn't the scripture said?
Yes, maandiko inasema.
No eye has seen.
Hakuna jicho limeona.
No ear has heard.
Hakuna sikio limesikia.
Neither has it entered the minds of men.
Hata haijaingia kwa akili za
wanadamu. The things that God has prepared for those who love him.
Vitu ambazo Mungu ameandalia wale wanaompenda.
There are things that are hidden.
Kuna vitu vimefichwa.
It is like eggs.
Ni kama mayai.
Which the mother hen is lying on.
Yule kuku mama analalia.
And every day he wakes up and you just see eggs.
Na kila wakati akiamka unaona mayai.
They are already spoiled because you cannot eat them.
Sasa yameharibika uwezi kaanga.
But the mother chicken.
Lakini mama kuku
is laying on those eggs every single day.
Amelalia hayo mayai kila siku.
At times staying 2 days without leaving that place.
Wakati mwingine siku mbili anamalizia.
And if the mother hen will go out, he will go out for only 10 minutes.
Na mama wa kuku akitoka nje anakimbia ndani.
And then he will go back to his eggs.
Na atarudi kwa mayai yake.
So patient.
Amesubiri.
3 good weeks, 21 days.
Siku 21 wiki 3.
And suddenly,
na ghafla,
there is a new life.
Kuna uhai mpya.
Which is coming from the rotten eggs.
Ambao inatoka kwa mayai yaliyoharibika.
There is new life.
Kuna
which you could not have seen there before. There is a process which the mother hen has made the eggs to go through by releasing his body temperature to the temperature of the eggs. And in 3 weeks, 21 days, there is new life. That is what I'm calling manifesting. 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 Somebody hearing me this morning. You are already in a process. You are about to manifest. There is something in you. Nobody has seen until now. Nobody knows until now. It is only a matter of time and connecting with the grace of God that releases the ability to manifest. Because you cannot manifest with your own strength. This thing is bigger than the ability of men. Education is good.
Elimu ni nzuri.
Riches are good.
Utajiri ni mzuri.
Hard work is good.
Bidii ni mzuri.
Having good parents are good.
Oh, kuwa na wazazi wazuri ni vyema.
But let me tell you the truth.
Lakini wacha niwaambie
ukweli. Let me tell you the truth.
Wacha niwaambie ukweli.
There is a grace of manifesting the glory of God.
Kuna neema ya kudhihirisha utukufu wa Mungu.
When it comes upon you.
Inapokujia wewe,
you become greater than those with education.
Unafanyika mkuu kuliko walio wasomi.
You become greater than those who have been hard working.
Unafanyika mkuu kuliko wale
wanaokuwa. You become greater than those with good parents.
Unafanyika bora kuliko walio na mastajiri.
It is called the grace to manifest.
Inaitwa neema ya kudhihirika.
Now this guy who was born blind.
Huyu jamaa alisaliwa kipofu.
We are not told how long, how many years he was, how old he was.
Atuambiwe alikuwa na umri gani.
But he was somewhere.
Lakini alikuwa mahali.
Disciples ask.
Eh, wanafunzi wanauliza.
Who sinned?
Sasa, nani alitenda dhambi hapa?
Is it this man?
Ni huyu jamaa?
Or his
father?
So that he was born blind.
Ili asaliwe.
What did Jesus say?
Yesu alisema nini?
Jesus said, listen.
Yesu akasema.
It is not this man who sins.
Sio huyu jamaa alitenda dhambi.
It is not his parent.
Hata sio maperu.
This blindness is not an issue of sin.
Hii sasa upofu sio matokeo ya dhambi.
This is a situation.
Hii ni hali.
That is a study case.
Sasa,
this is a study case.
Hii ni funzo, yani kitu ya kufunza watu.
This is a classroom.
Hii ni darasa iko hapa.
This guy is a specimen.
Huyu jamani dhihirisho.
He is a specimen.
Ni mtu wa kuonyesha.
Through whom?
Kupitia yeye.
The power of God, the glory of God,
utukufu wa Mungu,
shall be manifested.
Itadhihirishwa.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I came to tell somebody here today.
Nilikuja kuambia mtu hapa.
You are a study case.
Wewe ni jambo la
kufunza. Your life is a study case.
Maisha yako ni ya funzo.
Maybe you never went to school.
Labda hukuenda shule.
You didn't have parents who could educate you.
Labda hukuwa na wazazi wangekuelimisha.
Maybe you never went beyond class 5.
Labda hukupita darasa la 5.
Maybe you didn't know even your father or your mother.
Labda hukujua baba ama mama
yako. Maybe you came from adulterous and polygamous family.
Labda ulitoka katika jamii ya usinzi na ya wake wengi.
Maybe you had a relationship that never worked.
Labda ulikuwa na uhusiano ambao hukutenda kazi.
Somebody gave you a baby and then left you to go wherever you go.
Mtu akakupea mtoto ukatunga mimba na ukapata mtoto.
Maybe you come from a malfunction of marriage.
Labda umetoka kwa ndoa ambayo.
Maybe you have lost your job.
Labda umepoteza kazi.
Maybe somebody you owe somebody money and he is not giving you peace.
Labda una pesa ya mtu na akupei amani.
Maybe your house has been closed more often than not.
Yaani labda nyumba yako imefungwa mara mingi sana.
There is a problem.
Kuna shida.
There is a brightness.
Kuna upofu
that has been following you.
Ambao umekuwa ukikufuata.
Maybe you have been in and out of hospital.
Labda umekuwa hospitali.
You are seeking children.
Umekuwa na watoto wagonjwa.
You don't know what to enjoy good health is.
Hujui kufurahia afya nzuri ni nini.
And the question is,
na swali ni
why are these things happening to me?
Kwa nini haya mambo yananitendekea?
I came to tell somebody here today.
Kuja kuambia mtu hapa leo.
I don't know whether you are here.
Mimi sijui kama.
I don't know whether this message is yours.
Mimi sijui kama.
If it is not yours, don't struggle. If it is not yours, just leave it alone.
Kama sio wako ujumbe wachana nayo.
It could be for one person.
Labda ni ya mtu mmoja.
The Lord sent me to tell you.
Bwana alinituma ni
kwambie. The situation you've been going through.
Ile hali umekuwa ukipitia.
It is a situation.
Ni hali.
That through which.
Ambayo kupitia.
God will make you to manifest His glory, His power, His healing, His favor, His goodness, His mercy, His victory in your life.
Kwamba Mungu atadhihirisha nguvu, ushindi, uweza, uponyaji na nguvu zake maishani mwako.
This man is like that.
Huyu mtu ako hivi.
So that the works of God,
ili ya kwamba kazi za Mungu,
may be manifested,
iweze kudhihirishwa,
through him,
kupitia yeye,
through him,
kupitia yeye.
He is not just a bright man.
Yeye sio tu kipofu.
He is a specimen.
Lakini ni mfano.
He is a study case.
Yeye ni wa kuonyesha.
He is a person people will be running with from him.
Yeye ni mtu watu watajifunza kwake.
May that be your story.
Na iwe
may that
yako.
Be your story.
Na iwe andidi yako
hiyo. In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
This man,
huyu jamaa,
was set by God.
Alitumwa na Mungu
to join the ranks of other people.
Ili aweze kuungana na vyo vya watu wengine.
Who manifested the power of God in their life and through their life.
Ambao walidhihirisha nguvu za Mungu katika maisha yao na kupitia maisha
yao. So that one day.
Ili ya kwamba hiyo siku moja.
If somebody say.
Mtu akisema.
God is able to open the eyes of the blind.
Mungu anaweza kufungua macho ya kipofu.
This guy can stand up.
Huyo jamaa anaweza inuka.
And say, I am one of them.
Anaweza sema mimi ni moja wao.
I am one of them.
Mimi ni moja wao.
I
am the one who he opened his eyes.
Mimi ndiye alifungua macho yangu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many are with me? How many are with me?
Wangapi wako na
sure kani? Enough, that is what happened.
Ukweli hiyo ndio ilitendeka.
Because shortly after that,
baada ya muda
Jesus
kidogo,
took some clay.
Yesu alichukua udongo.
Why clay? Because man is created from clay.
Maana mwanadamu ameumbwa na mafumbo.
So these eyes,
hii macho,
all they needed is the clay.
Yalihitaji,
which is the main component of the creation of man.
Dongo ambao ni sehemu ya umbile la mwanadamu.
And then he is supposed to put some saliva.
Na anatemea mate.
Why saliva? This is not ordinary saliva.
Kwa nini mate? Hii sio mate ya kawaida hii.
It is the breath of life.
Hii ni pumzi ya
uhai. Because man in the original, he was clay, he was sad, he was soil, and God breathed the breath of life.
Maana mwanadamu alikuwa udongo, alikuwa matope, lakini Mungu akapulizia pumzi ya uhai.
So he put the saliva.
Kwa hivyo anatemea mate
and made clay from it.
Na anatengeneza udongo pale, matope, matope.
What happened?
Anafanya nini baada ya matope? Biblia inasema
he put it in his eyes.
Anaweka kwa macho yake.
And not a little.
Na sio kidogo.
A lot.
Mingi.
A lot.
Mingi.
So the guy is more brighter than the bright.
Kwa hiyo jamaa sasa amekuwa kipofu maradufu.
He is now more brighter than he was.
Ako kipofu kuliko vile alikuwa.
And now he waits for the next instruction.
Na anangojea maagizo hayo mengine.
Then he is told, "Go!"
Anaambiwa aenda.
And wash.
Unawe
in the pool
katika mbirika
of Siloam.
La Siloam.
And that word Siloam,
na hiyo jina Siloam,
the Bible tells us in translated it means,
Biblia inatuambia kwa kutafsiri ni
sent.
Kutumwa.
Sent.
Kutumwa.
Tell your neighbor sent.
Kutumwa.
So what is God doing? What is Jesus doing?
Yesu anafanya nini?
He is sending him.
Anamtuma.
Why sending?
Kwa nini anamtuma?
Because
kwa sababu
he was waiting to see his obedience.
Alikuwa anangojea kuona utiifu wake.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
if you are a willing and obedient, you will eat the good of the land.
Ukiwa mtiifu na kutaka utakula mema ya nchi.
What stands between you and the grace of manifesting the glory of God?
Kile kimesimama kati yako na wewe na kudhihirisha utukufu wa Mungu.
Oh, the grace of manifesting.
Ama neema ya kudhihirisha.
It is driven. It is characterized.
Yani,
it is made to quicken.
Yani inastahili itiwe nguvu ama ifanyike kutenda.
By the spirit of obedience.
Kwa roho ya utiifu.
How many are with me? How many are with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The more you are obedient to the word of God, the more and the faster the glory of God shall manifest in your life.
Vile unaendelea kutii neno la Mungu, ndivyo utasindi kudhihirisha neema ya Mungu maishani mwako.
The more disobedient you are to the word of God, the more time it will take for you to ever manifest, if at all you will ever manifest.
Vile utasindi kuwa utii neno la Mungu ama kugaidi neno la Mungu, ndivyo hautaweza kudhihirisha neema ya Mungu maishani mwako.
Number one quality that was in Jesus.
Jambo la kwanza lilikuwa ndani ya Yesu.
He was obedient to the Father.
Alikuwa mtiifu kwa Baba.
And that is why Jesus,
na ndio sababu Yesu,
when he came here on earth,
alipokuja hapa duniani,
he manifested,
alidhihirisha
the presence and the glory of his Father.
Uwepo na utukufu wa Baba.
And before that, because that is what I want to finish with.
Na kabla ya hiyo, maana hiyo ndio
Romans chapter 8 verse 19.
Warumi sura ya 8 mstari 19.
Everybody hear this. Romans 8:19.
Sasa Warumi 8:19.
Everybody lead with me. 1, 2, 3. For the earnest expectation of the creation waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. Read it again. For the
earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of.
In other words, what it says is this.
Kile inasema ni
the whole creation.
Maumbile yote.
The whole world.
Dunia yote.
It is waiting. It is standing still.
Inangojea.
It is waiting for something to happen.
Inangojea jambo litendeke.
It is waiting for the manifestations of the sons of God.
Inangojea kudhihirishwa kwa wana wa Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And as my brother was telling me, it is not the children of God.
Na kama vile ndugu yangu alikuwa ananiambia sio watoto wa Mungu.
It is the manifestation of sons.
Ni kudhihirishwa kwa wana.
That word sons, the difference between sons and children is that sons have an inheritance, children have no inheritance.
Yaani tofauti kati ya wana ni kwamba
children have inheritance, but they have not matured to receive the inheritance.
Yeah.
Sons are the people in the place to receive their inheritance.
Yes, watoto ni kweli wana urithi, lakini hawaja komaa kufika mahali pa urithi, lakini wana ni watu waliokomaa tayari kurithi.
So the whole creation,
kwa hivyo maumbile,
the whole world,
ulimwengu wote,
is waiting,
inangojea,
for the manifestation,
kwa kudhihirisho,
of the sons of God,
ya wana wa Mungu.
And we are in a season,
na tuko katika majira,
when the sons of God in the church, in Kenya, here in the house of worship and healing, they are going to be manifested.
Yani tuko mahali ambapo wana, hapa katika kanisa hili, watadhihirishwa.
Now shake somebody up, tell them it is my season to manifest. That one does not believe it. Look for somebody behind. Look for somebody behind you. Tell them it is my season.
It's my season
to manifest. The whole world is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. And when you manifest, you will change where you live. You will change your address. Your life will suddenly change. There is a you that will manifest in Jesus' name. Now, the obedience to the word of God will quicken your manifestation.
Sasa kutii neno la Mungu vile utatii, itafanya kudhirika iwe kwa haraka.
Jesus,
Yesu,
he did manifest the glory of his Father.
Yeye alidhirisha utukufu wa Baba.
John chapter 2 verse 11, please give me very fast, I want to finish. This is the last thing I'm saying. Two speech and I'm done. John 2:11.
Yohana 2:11.
1, 2, 3, everybody read with me. This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee, and manifested forth his glory, and his disciples believed on him. This was his first miracle.
Hii ni muujiza wake wa kwanza.
Of turning water into wine.
Ya kugeuza maji kuwa divai.
But when that miracle happened,
lakini muujiza huo ulipotokea,
what happened?
Nini kilitokea?
It manifested the glory of Jesus.
Ilidhihirisha utukufu wa.
He was not an ordinary person.
Hakuwa mtu wa kawaida.
He presence of God was upon him.
Upepo wa Mungu ulikuwa juu yake.
And his disciples believed in him.
Na wanafunzi wake wakaamini.
There are people who will never believe in you until God makes you to manifest his glory.
Sasa kuna watu hawatakuamini mpaka Mungu adhihirishe utukufu wake ndani yako.
And then it is recorded in John 17 verse number 6.
Na imere na kiliwa katika Yohana 17 mstari.
Jesus is in the Gethsemane.
Yesu yuko pale.
And he is praying.
Na anaomba.
What does it say? 1 2 3 I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Listen to me. Jesus told the Father,
Yesu akamwambia Baba,
I have manifested your glory to these men.
Nimedhihirisha utukufu wako kwa hao watu.
Amen.
Amen.
And because of that, they have known they are not of the world, just like I am not of the world.
Na kupitia hiyo wamefahamu wao si wa ulimwengu kama vile mimi sio wa ulimwengu.
Therefore, Father, keep them by your name.
Kwa hivyo Baba, wahifadhi kwa jina lako.
Just like Jesus manifested the glory of God.
Kama vile Yesu alidhihirisha utukufu wa Baba.
Because Jesus was the grace of manifestation.
Maana Yesu alikuwa neema ya udhihirisho.
All of us that believe in his name,
wale wote tunaamini jina lake,
it is our time,
ni wakati wetu,
it is our season,
ni majira yetu,
to manifest,
kudhihirisha,
to manifest,
kudhihirisha,
to manifest,
kudhihirisha,
to manifest,
kudhihirisha.
May the millionaire in you start to manifest.
Wacha
start to manifest,
start
to manifest in the name of the Lord Jesus. I say, may the great personality that God has called you to be start start to manifest in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Wacha ile ukuu umeitiwa ndani yako ianze kudhihirika sasa katika jina la Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
May the international business person that God has called you to be right now under this anointing start to manifest. Start
yes.
to manifest.
Yanze kudhihirika.
Start to manifest.
Yanze
in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu Kristo.
May what you could not do for the last 20 years of your life.
Wacha
kile. May you be given the grace to manifest it before the end of this year. Before the end
yes.
of this year.
Yes.
Before the end
kabla ya mwaka
of this year.
Kabla ya mwisho wa mwaka.
In Jesus' name.
Kile
in the name of Jesus,
kachirine.
Receive it.
Katika jina
in
Yesu
the name
upoke.
Of the Lord Jesus.
Ipoke.
May you receive. Receive the grace to manifest. May you walk with the grace to manifest. Receive the grace to manifest. Receive the grace to manifest. Receive the grace to manifest. May you manifest. May your life manifest. May your gifts manifest. Receive the power to manifest. May you 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 be manifested. May you be manifested. Somebody say, Lord. Lord, cause me to be manifested.
Cause me to be manifested.
Stand up with your two feet.
Simama na miguu yako.
Stand up with your two feet.
Simama na miguu yako.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Katina na Bwana Yesu.
Once again, somebody say, Lord.
Lord,
cause me to manifest.
Cause me to manifest.
Let the greatness in me.
Let the greatness in me
manifest.
Manifest
in this season.
In this season.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Let the riches in me.
Let the riches in me.
Manifest.
Manifest.
In the name of Jesus.
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 Somebody say, every blindness.
Every blindness.
Every blindness.
Every blindness.
That is hindered. That has hindered.
That has hindered.
My manifestation.
My manifestation.
Right now.
Right now.
Get out of my life.
Get out of my life.
Let that blindness get out.
Get
come
out
of the blindness. Let it leave you. Every blindness.
From my
let
life.
It come out.
Oh.
Let it come out.
I declare.
Let it come out.
I
let it come out. Let it come out.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Every blindness.
Come out. Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out of my life.
Come out of my life.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In
the name of Jesus.
In Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. Somebody say, every power of the enemy.
Every power of the enemy.
From my father's family.
From my father's family.
That has hindered.
That has hindered.
My manifestation.
My manifestation.
Right now.
Right now.
Break!
Break
by fire!
By fire!
Command it to break!
Break!
Let the break! Let the power break! Let the power break! Let the power break! In the name of the Lord Jesus!
Break!
Break! Let the power break!
Let the power break!
Jesus! In the name of Jesus!
We just
in the name of Jesus!
Let the power
break!
Manifestation!
Break!
In the name of Jesus!
Break!
Let the power
break!
Let the power
break!
Let the power
break!
In the name of Jesus!
In Jesus' name. I say this. You are a study case. Master. Who sinned?
Nani, bwana, nani alitenda dhambi?
This man.
Uyu mtu,
or his parents.
Ama ni wasasi wake.
Say no.
Apana.
The situation as it is.
Vile hali ilivyo.
It is so that.
Ni kwamba.
God's.
Mungu.
Power.
Nguvu za Mungu.
May be manifested.
Siweze kudhihirika.
Through him.
Kupitia yeye.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This man was being counted.
Huyu jamaa aliyesabiwa.
Among Abraham.
Kati ya Abraham.
And other heroes.
Na wale masujaa
so wengine. When you say God is able to open barren oops.
Hili unaposema Mungu anafungua tumbo ambazo ni tasa.
Sarah can stand up and say, yes, yes, yes.
Sarah anaweza simama na aseme, ndio, ndio, ndio.
I am one of them.
Mimi ni moja wao.
Elizabeth can stand on the other side.
Elizabeth anaweza simama upande ule mwingine.
Say, yeah.
Aseme, ndio, I am here.
Niko hapa.
I was one of them.
Nilikuwa moja wao. Hannah can stand on the other side of the church.
Hannah yako upande ule mwingine wa kanisa.
And she will say, yes, sir.
Aseme ndio Bwana.
Negwa, 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 negwa.
Ni kweli.
Hiyo maneno ni ya kweli.
Pero
kanisa. Mimi ni moja wao.
Ni kweli.
Nilifunguliwa tupo. Matupo nilifunguliwa.
Nilifunguliwa.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When the Bible says,
wakati Biblia inasema,
God can take people from the fiery furnace and from the lion's den.
Ya kwamba Mungu anaweza toa watu kwa tanuri ya moto na kwa tundu la simba.
Already it has manifested.
Tayari imedhihirika.
And somebody somewhere there will called Daniel will lift up his hand and say, "Yes, yes, yes!"
Na mtu kwa jina Danieli atasimama pale aseme ndio, ndio, ndio.
I am one of them.
Mimi ni moja wao.
Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego, they will come from somewhere outside.
Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego watakimbia kutoka nje mahali.
Wearing the belt of ushers.
Wakiwa wamevalia kamba ya kuwa masemanzi.
Because they are already the ushers in heaven.
Maana hao ni masemanzi pale mbinguni.
They will say, we are one of those guys.
Watasema sisi ni moja wao wapendwa.
We manifested and we saw God taking people from the lion's den, from the fiery furnace.
Na tukaona Mungu akitoa watu kwa tanuri ya moto.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
When you say God can heal a paralytic,
wakati unasema Mungu anaweza ponya mtu ambaye amepooza.
The guy who was that 80 years old at the pool of Bethesda will stand up.
Yule jamaa alikuwa pale amepooza katika mbiriga ya Bethesda atasimama pale.
And he will do some gymnastics.
Na atafanya sarakasi hapo.
And some aerobics.
Yeah, somersault.
And some somersault.
And somersault.
And he will say, I am one of them.
Nani atasema mimi ni moja wao.
This my body I could not turn this way.
Hii mwili yangu singegeuza hivi.
But nowadays.
Lakini siku hizi.
I can somersault.
Naweza somersault.
Hallelujah. Bwana asifiwe.
Hallelujah.
And the guy in John 9.
Na jamaa katika Yohana 9.
When you say Jesus can heal, open bright eyes.
Unaposema Yesu anaweza fungua macho kipofu.
He stands out.
Anasimama.
He says,
anasema,
look at my eyes.
Angalia macho yangu na
I have not worn spectacles for the last 50 years.
Mimi sijafalia miwani kwa miaka 50.
But I was born blind.
Lakini nilikuwa nimesaliwa kipofu.
Until I met with the grace to manifest.
Paka nilipokutana na neema ya kudhihirisha.
And from that time,
na kutoka wakati huo,
I don't wear spectacles.
Mimi sifalia miwani tena.
Hallelujah.
Hapana.
You are a study case.
Wewe ni funzo ya
God will make you to manifest.
Mungu atakusababisha udhihirishe.
Whatever you want to become.
Kile unataka kufanyika.
Whatever it is your dream.
Kile ambacho ni ndoto yako.
Let manifest.
Udhihirike.
In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Lift up your hands.
Inua mikono yako.
Now Father.
Baba sasa.
I thank you for this word.
Nakushukuru kwa hawa.
We receive it in our hearts.
Tuipokea kwa mioyo yetu.
Give us the ability.
Tupe uwezo.
To manifest.
Kudhihirisha.
Your glory.
Utukufu wako.
In this season.
Katika majira haya.
Let your purposes be fulfilled.
Wacha makusudi yako.
Let our destinies be realized.
Wacha tamati zetu zifike.
Let our potential be seen.
Wacha uwezo wetu.
Let your purpose in us be accomplished.
Wacha kusudi letu kwako.
Bless every person.
Bariki kila mtu.
And do them good.
Na wafanye vema.
Because we ask this.
Maana tumeomba haya.
In Jesus name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
And someone shout amen.
Na mtu aseme amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We thank you.
I believe that the word of God has been a blessing to you today, and I believe that the word that you have heard is going to transform your life. Just be a doer of the word of God. And right now you are there, you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, I would wish to pray together with you. Say with me, Lord Jesus, I come to you. Forgive my sins and write my name in the book of life. I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And today, I have made up my mind that I am a son in the kingdom. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving me. And thank you for your purpose in my life. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have prayed that prayer, may the Lord bless you. I want to assure you, Jesus is in your heart and you are a new creation. May you join a church that teaches the word of the Lord, and may you grow in the knowledge of Him. And if you live near Dagoretti Janga corner in his environs, or here in Nairobi, we welcome you to our services in the house of worship and healing. God bless you. You could be there, you are going through situations in your life. I would wish to pray together with you, maybe in your marriage, in your place of work, in your health, and in whichever situation that you could be facing. Father, I pray for my viewer right now. May you deliver them from any situation that surrounds them in the name of Jesus Christ. And let the power that is there in your word bring change and transformation in their situation. And I pray, my Father, that I shall give a testimony of the goodness of God. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray and I give thanks. Amen and amen. Keep us a feedback through the numbers that are on your screen right now. Even as you tell us what God is doing, write us a text and share with us of the testimonies the Lord has done, even as you've been watching this program. The Lord God bless you. Thank you so much. Even as you tune in next week at a time like now for the same program, Going Beyond. May the Lord continue to bless you. Until next time, you are blessed of the Lord. Amen.